from the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, white with foam.
Why did you leave? Did I not give you what you wanted? Have you forgotten I'm here? It sure is quiet without you. I'm falling apart. Things just aren't the same anymore. I feel the end is near. Won't be long now. These are long days, and even longer nights. Remember me when I'm gone.
What is it about a shopping mall that has nothing left in it that bewilders the mind? What is it about the 24,000 of you that watch my videos and try to put into perspective and understand why exactly you find this topic interesting? The Forest Fair Mall, Forest Fair Village, Cincinnati Mills, Cincinnati Mall, whatever you want to call it, is the prime example of poor management and a picture into what American retail is going through right now. You're looking at a property that had aspirations of grandeur, and less than one calendar year into its opening, it was put up for sale. The LJ Hooker Company out of Australia filed for bankruptcy, and this place pretty much was doomed from the start. Several attempts were made to revitalize the mall and change it. And the mall that you're seeing right now, that I'm currently walking through, believe it or not, is dramatically different than the opening version of what this mall looked like. Where grand arcade games and amusement park level rides once stood, now is drab carpet and pastel colors reeking of the late 90s into early 2000s. This mall is on life support, and the only thing that is keeping this property open is a arcade and two huge anchors for the most part, and one children's jungle gym slash play area. Without that, and without that revenue, in addition to the tax income and stuff that they hang on to, this mall probably would be closed already. It's been sitting for years and is a place that I love to visit. But getting more into the psyche of things and kind of my buddy Sal's mantra here, I want to know, what is it that drives me to film these places? What is it that drives me to risk safety, and go into places that are asbestos and mold-filled, abandoned, wet, just disgusting places, closed places, dying places. What is it that makes the mind want to visit these places? And I've never fully understood it, and I don't know that I ever will, but I know a couple things have come to light. This is such a big and imposing structure. I myself, a 6'2" man in a super big, super empty, super massive structure, is just a feeling that I cannot describe. It's very, very overwhelming to just be able to walk around in here with no people, and no air conditioning, by the way, and just have the run of the place. Call me the mayor of Deadmallville, if you will, for it is I that on the day I visit said place am the king of the castle. No pun intended, just a funny statement. You can do whatever you want. You can walk in any direction you want to. You can lay down. You can look. You can take pictures, not legally. You can do pretty much whatever you want to. And the lawlessness of that, meaning that you really have no one to really judge you or look at you. I mean, you're kind of judging the property for what it is and what it was. It's really just something that just kind of blows my mind. Every place that I go to, I get a different feeling about. But this one blows my mind the most. Well, not the most aesthetically driven mall. It certainly does have its character and color and characteristics that really are something that is just something I can't put into words. It's hard to really describe. I was back here Memorial Day weekend and came back a few weeks later en route to my trip to Indiana for malls that you're going to see later. And I just had to stop here one last time and get some more footage and just walk around and really just soak in this property. I hope that you enjoy my tour. I hope you enjoy the silence and the vastness of the Forest Fair Village Mall in Forest Park, Ohio. This is Anthony with Ace's Adventures. I'd like to give a special shout out to my friend Janae from Chicago, who lended the audio track for the piece that you heard early on. Those were her vocals. I really appreciate her getting involved on this project, and there is much more stuff coming with her in the future, so stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching. This is Anthony with Ace's Adventures. I am truly humbled by all of your support as we drive to 25,000 subscribers up and onward. Without you, none of this would be possible. Thank you to my friends in the Deadmall community who support me and encourage me to be a better person, a better creator, and a better YouTuber. Thank you so much, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your holiday weekend, and we'll be back soon with more content.